your eye like a big pizza pie. That's amore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Here we go. I just want to welcome everybody to our third edition of our cooking show. This is a Super Bowl. Kind of emphasize that we're getting close to Super Bowl. So we try to think, anyway, Coach, of people that we might know that might be really interested in Super Bowl and football, have some snacks and goodies. And so I had to dig deep and got him out of jail, Jackson County Sheriff, Tom Phillips, who's been a good friend of mine for a long time. We actually grew up together in Independence. And I finally twisted his arm and talked him into coming. I know you really can cook.
Really can cook.
Now, we got a special guest, isn't that right?
We do.
Now, for real special guest.
For real. I mean, this is an expert chef.
Expert. We're from southern France.
From southern France, the very south part of France.
The very south part of France. Well, why don't you go ahead and introduce him, see what we got.
Well, we were doing a international investigation involving a lot of stolen property and things like that. So we came across this guy while we were at a restaurant eating, and he was just a renowned fresh chef there in southern France.
Fresh chef?
A fresh chef, yes, he was.
Too bad he's... never mind, I won't go there.
I didn't really get time to check his credentials yet, though, but everything we hear is that he is a fantastic
top-notch
chef.
Dude, yeah.
So I'd like to introduce the world-renowned chef from very south of France, Laurence Estuaire.
Let's give a big round of applause. I tell you what, you're definitely dressed for the occasion.
It's my pleasure, monsieur.
Well, tell me a little bit about yourself. I mean, I can't hardly believe we have somebody as astute as yourself here.
What is astute?
I don't know. I really don't know. I thought it sounded good.
That's what they are in the audience.
Tell me, what's astute?
Astute.
Astute.
Well, I'm a graduate of the International Institute of Culinary Arts. I apologize, I'm not able to speak your language so good. So if you'd bear with me, Super Bowl, a tradition here.
A big time tradition, you bet. You bet.
I'm very honored to be here in Blue Springs.
You got it.
Blue Springs.
You got it.
Kansas?
Missouri. No, not Kansas.
Oh,
no.
Sorry.
Yeah. You got to kind of watch what you say there.
Yeah.
You want to get back to France, you better be careful. I know the law around here.
Home of the Wildcats?
You got Wildcats and Jaguars.
Jaguars.
Matter of fact, we're in
Jaguar land.
There you go, Coach. Jump on that.
I've heard of that great team.
You bet. You bet.
Well, I'm very happy to be here, and I understand that the sheriff who asked me to be here has got his recipe for some dish from Mexico, the Spanish?
That is correct. A little Spanish dish.
I would love to see you cook. The last time I saw you, you were, scarfing down. And so if you would go ahead in the show, I would love to watch.
No problem. Of course, the theme is Super Bowl parties, so one of the great dishes, of course, any Super Bowl is your chips and dip, but you just don't want to pour salsa and just that's boring. So you got to have a good dip, and guacamole is one of my favorites. So that's why.
It looks like it.
Yep,
it
does.
Like.
And then the 10 pounds of fajitas that go with it. So.
But, Tommy only weighed 150 pounds in high school.
That is true. I did do that, and
I had hair
then
too.
I grew up, and see, Tim had hair, and Tim and I go way back, and part of the reason his mom was on a show not too long ago, and I know she makes cookies now for the teams, and she made cookies back then too, so she's part of my reason now that I'm have grown up.
There you go.
Now the secret to making good guacamole is choosing the right avocados. Now this is really a guy's dish to make because it's real messy and it's real easy. So what you do is, in my house, what I do is I get to make the mess, and then my wife gets to clean it up. So that's the fun part. But the real secret is getting the right avocado, and you want them ripe. Now, I did a real good job on this one because it says ripe. And so
that's high level.
They took away the secret on that one. Actually, this is the fun part, really, is slicing up the avocado and to get it out and just kind of go around in the circle.
Well, time out a bit, Tom.
Sure.
Is this guy really for real?
Well, actually is for real. Now, I didn't quite explain everything.
Okay.
I mean, he's an international chef,
You believe that, Coach?
No, I don't.
I'm
But he's kind of here on a work release program.
Work release.
Yeah.
But no, he's for real.
If he's dealing with you, probably
yes,
that's true.
I am a graduate of the International Institute of Culinary Arts.
Culinary?
Yes.
Does that mean you're cool, or what were you talking about?
Culinary, you know.
Eating.
Culinary.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, what can I say?
You don't believe me.
I believe you.
No, we got proof.
We got proof.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Dick Butkus, and years ago I was really into cooking, so I started Dick's Academy of Restaurant Eating, and I had various people come after finding out about it because I've whipped up such delicious cuisine that they said, "Why don't you get into the business, Dick, and teach other people and share that gift that you have?" And I thought, "Well, yeah, why not?" So this is what I did, and today I have, proud to say, one of my top students. He goes by Bubba, and he has not only taken lessons from me about cooking, but he's such an entrepreneur that you people here from Blue Springs, Missouri, might have come across a famous restaurant that one of my original students started. It's the Blue Springs Bistro, and I must say I'm really proud, and if I can do it, we're going to try to franchise this all across the country, along with my schools all over the country. So right now, I'd like to introduce Bubba.
Thanks, Dick. Today's recipe is possum on the half shell flambé. It's our number one most requested item at the bistro. The ingredients here, you can find in any grocery store. You don't have to go to a specialty store, health food store, anything like that. In fact, first of all, we squeeze the armadillo until we get all the liquid from the armadillo.
Mr. Bubba, shouldn't we wash our hands first?
Well, no, we don't do that because this is probably the best grill I've ever seen in my life. We use it down at the bistro to cook on all the time, and it is the International Fireplace and Grill, the star model thing.
What about trichinosis?
I played with that guy.
Yeah.
Making our famous guacamole here, and it's actually this is the fun part, is where you just cut the shell out, and this is also the messy part. But
I know I'm having fun.
Yes, you are.
Well, Coach's got to see. He's the cooker.
Cutting the shell.
You got to jump in there and see if you can cut with him.
Oh yeah,
wrong-handed.
Well, it tastes better if you use your left hand.
Why is that?
Because I'm left-handed.
Oh, okay.
You got a little shell in there.
Well, that's right.
Is that okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
That's edible.
Yeah, we'll take that.
Coach didn't even know there was a seed in it.
See the big old seed there? Yeah, he likes it.
I'm impressed.
Yeah.
This is your favorite?
This is my favorite. So, now, you don't want to put the seed in there, because unless you got an orthodontist for a father. So.
Could happen. Don't cut your thumb off.
No, that's a bad part, too. Bleeding does add a little flavor to it, but prefer not to do that. So. But anyway, that's
a little salty.
Just kind of a little salty. Yeah.
We're not as good as ashes.
Yeah. So that's what you do there is you.
So how many avocados we got?
Well, it depends how much dip you want to make. Now, for a large gathering, you may want to get 5 or 6 avocados and cut those up. Makes a
we're talking
good
Super
size.
Bowl party. We got Dick Buckus on the show and
yeah,
everybody
you
else.
Got all that.
On.
So you'd probably want 6 or 7 avocados. Makes up a large amount there. Want to try one?
Yeah, Coach.
Sure, I'd love to.
There you go.
Coach is a hands-on guy on this show. He's got a lot of skills.
I'm right-handed. Will that be?
Watch well, it'll though. Be all right. Probably just won't taste as good.
You're pretty smooth. Coach's a little down on the weather. He's doing this hurt.
Little
I'm kind of impressed. Well, to give him a hand, guys. Give him a hand. Give you a purple heart. Buddy.
Getting more inspired.
Have you ever cut one of these in your whole life?
No, never.
I didn't think so.
Look at that.
Like it.
First time.
Yay. That's good. That's great.
Yeah.
Pretty impressive, don't you think?
Yeah.
Now, since I did mine left-handed and his is right-handed, this will be an ambidextrous guacamole.
Never looking at it that way. You're about the smartest guy
I've ever met. You're going to have to look that word up.
How are you doing, Chef? Are they doing okay? You need to chime in here.
Very interesting. He's mentioned.
What about his technique? What do you think about his technique?
Excellent technique.
Look at that all in one.
Yeah, he's a little close to his thumb.
A little close to his thumb?
Yeah, with the blade.
Ow!
You you get that, Coach?
I'm having trouble getting this last piece.
I don't think
out.
You need to take the skin, too.
Okay.
You're never supposed to get the blood in the recipe.
It can take me a while to do the rest of that.
That's the main idea.
How long do we have?
That's the main idea.
We're rolling.
And then you just want to mash it up to where it's a good fine paste. And you can use a mixer. What I use is the meat tenderizer hammer. And I just wham it.
Well, you just beat it to death?
Just beat it to death.
The meat tenderizer.
The whammer?
Just the whammer.
I didn't think guys in police and stuff could have whammers and stuff like that.
We got all kinds of things.
I bet you do.
You can tase them or you can...
You can do it all.
You can do it all in there. But kind of electrifies it. And you'll mix that up to where it makes a good fine paste in there. And that takes a little while. But
you want to need a little time to work on it? Let me ask you again. Is this guy for real? Coach, you think this guy's for real?
I really do now. I'm convinced that he...
What do you guys out in the audience say? You think this guy's for real? How about the guys in the back?
Should tell for real.
Little iffy?
There's some doubts here.
We need to get back. We need to see what's up.
Well, I was going to talk about the type of eggs that we use in our recipes while the serif.
What kind of eggs do you use?
Chicken eggs, of course, organic, brown chicken eggs. That's all that we ever use.
Wait a minute, Coach. I really like you. Respect you. You think this guy's for real? Skunk eggs?
I'm not sure. Not with skunk.
Did you say skunk? You don't talk very good anyway.
You must. We got these special eggs, and I know what you're thinking. Skunk. They're eggs. Skunk eggs. But it's not what you think, because they really, really add a lot of flavor. Lots of flavor. And then we have one other egg. It's from the Mylamore bird.
What's a Mylamore?
Mylamore bird?
Yeah.
Well, it's a bird that's native to Florida. Again, it's not native to Jackson County, Missouri. But the Mylamore bird is a bird that at night, they come out at night. It's kind of similar to a crane. They have a long neck, short beak, and they bury their head in the sand at night, and they whistle through their ear. You can hear it for a mile or more.
Their ear?
No, it's a little bit of hot sauce, you know, special blend. Just a little bit, about a half a cup or so of cottage cheese. You know, you want to mix it up. It's important to...
Like I said, you know, the ingredients were sort of like ballpark ingredients that I created. But what I liked about Bubba and his creativity, as you can see, a lot of the things like cottage cheese, like the hot sauce, the other salsa, all these things blended together really enhance a sort of different flavor. And that's why, I'm happy to say that I'm very proud of Bubba. You know, the Blue Springs Bistro has been ranked up there. If you fly Southwest a lot or anything like that, you'll see it in their magazine as that restaurant is rated number one in the...
I got down here, Tom, one cup dried red onions. Is that right?
It's diced.
Diced.
The sea
it's supposed to be diced, but
we can dried dry them too.
Yep.
Yeah.
Start adding your onions.
Those
onions
are dried red onions.
Dried.
Diced. And your tomatoes.
How many you got there? Two cups? What's that?
Well, it depends on, again, how much you want to cook up there.
All right.
So,
you're rolling.
This is what most people don't realize to put in this, because this really makes
this
the
is
flavor.
A key tea?
This is a tea here, the garlic salt.
Give you bad breath things.
Yeah, but Super Bowl party, so,
TV.
Like, you know.
There you go.
Okay. That's good.
You're just watching a bunch of big football players.
So there you go.
Kills the vampires.
I've never seen anybody garlic in
lost the accent there for a second.
There's another secret ingredient.
That might have to be a cut.
Okay, the accent's back.
What you got going here?
Secret ingredients,
okay.
Excuse me there.
You speak a lot of languages, don't you? I'm impressed. What do we put in it now, Haas?
This is lime. You want to add lime.
Lime in your guacamole dip?
Squeeze
it in there.
Lime on the
what's up with that?
There, buddy?
Squeeze it in there. That's good. That's good. Oh, that's good.
I didn't see that on the recipe. You could.
No. Lime. Don't forget the lime.
Sometimes you got to ad lib.
Recipe.
So, and you sprinkle a little cheese on there.
You're the guy who dumps the cheese on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember?
Yeah, you got a little finesse to
you.
You
got some finesse. And that's it.
That's it.
Let me ask you this, though. I'm still a little worried because, you know, you got to have credibility with young people, and they're all here watching us, helping us out today. Is this guy really for real?
Yeah, he's for real. Now, you may have seen a similarity in the guy on the video, and there may be some family resemblance there, but no, this guy is definitely a graduate of the culinary art school.
I thought I was the only one who mixed stuff with my hands.
But the foundation. Now, all we have to do, you want to heat this up about 1,100 degrees.
I know she's the can top's still in there. Doesn't that cut you?
You have to be real careful. Doug, don't try this at home without special gloves. Now, I've been doing this for so many years, it's just kind of second nature to me. So, yeah, you do have to be careful. So, please. Now, all we need to add the meat. This is the tenderloin, and this is the chop. Let's see what we got here now. This is great for tailgating.
Oh, yeah. And I understand around Blue Springs, you do a lot of tailgating.
A lot of tailgating. We're big Chiefs fans here.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yes, yes. We're Wildcats.
Well, I'm glad.
Jaguars fans.
Turn that side down.
Oops.
But... Okay. Well, you know, that's just the flavor.
Yeah.
When you get it up to a little steam in it like that, it's just not quite to a boil that really releases the flavor.
Yeah. Do we have a serving plate handy?
Let's just cut that off and just show you.
Oh, look how tender.
Yeah. Look at that.
Oh, that is perfect. That is absolutely perfect. Possum.
That's what you want.
On the half shell.
Okay, so that wraps up my good friend Tommy. I tell you what, guys, why don't you guys take a little sample, and we're going to really check the chef out here to see if he can really do anything here in a second. Give him a whirl. It's all right.
We'll get that.
Good. Take a shot of it. It's good stuff.
Let's hear it first, Chef Tom.
Yeah, let's give Tom a now, let me ask you something, Coach. Do you really think this guy over there to your right is for real?
This guy?
Mm-hmm.
For real? He's got to be for real.
All right, I admit, I'm busted.
Okay? You're busted?
My real name, I'm not from France. I am from the South, and my nickname is Bubba. And that guy that you saw there, unfortunately, is me. I want to thank Gary Jones for getting me dressed up in this penguin suit. It's hard to cook in a penguin suit, but I really do cook occasionally. My kids, my wife won't eat anything I cook, so I have plenty to eat at home, as you can tell. What I'm going to cook today is a Super Bowl recipe, and it's for real recipe. How many of you like salmon?
Yeah, I do.
I love salmon. How many of you like eggs? Well, we're going to mix them, and the dish is not going to be...
We don't want them skunk eggs, though.
No skunk eggs today. The dish is not going to be called salmon egga, okay? It's too close to something else. It's a Sunday Super Bowl surprise is what this is. And really what it is, it's a combination of eggs and some peppers and things like that. And it's very healthy. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with some olive oil. And how many of you use this, Pam? I've got it on high here for a very good reason. Now, this is a non-stick 10-inch pan. The reason it's non-stick is because it's real easy to coat. Be careful when you put it on high heat, though, but what happens is this. You can take a tablespoonful of olive oil. Here's a little trick. You know, if you put 2 tablespoons of olive oil in a dish, there's one, and then there's two. I don't like to use the Pam kind of stuff. I'll heat this up.
How come you don't like to use the Pam kind of stuff?
Well, because it's got an aerosol in it, I just don't care for it. I don't like the taste. Yeah, it's kind of a health deal.
We're actually cooking here.
But actually, what we can do here is you can just coat the pan. And what will happen is if you put 2 tablespoons full of olive oil in a dish, how many of you can tell me how many calories I just poured in here? Yes, sir. 24 calories? Try 240 calories. 1 tablespoon of olive oil,
right?
1 tablespoon has 120 calories. So what I do is, now watch this, I can pour
very carefully. I can get one. I can get at least two. The oil expands. So what I've got left here is just a coated pan. You want to turn the heat down.
You're the smartest guy I've ever been around.
Not hardly.
Okay.
But anyway, that's what I do for the olive oil. And so what you end up having about 24 calories after you coat it.
Right. You the man.
You the man.
Give him a hand. You the man.
Now, my foundation of this dish is jalapeno peppers. How many of you like jalapenos and love them fresh? So what I do is I will cut up at least one, depending on how and the way that I cut them, is I will just either quarter them like this, and then you can chop them. I like them a little chunky.
You're pretty good with that, though.
So, anyway, that's the way I cut my jalapenos.
Could you have Tim try some of them? I'd like to see him cut some jalapenos.
I can't. Well, you know, what you do first, Coach, is just try one. You like jalapenos?
Yeah.
Try one of those.
They're really hot.
No, not bad.
No, they're good.
Very good taste.
I need something in my own.
Now, I like a lot of color in my
The guy was on
dish.
TV.
You know, he didn't want to handle that knife.
Oh, no.
I like a lot of color. So we've got red, we've got orange, and we've got yellow bell peppers, and they're very sweet. So all you got to do, just cut you a little strip of each one off. If you get too much bell pepper in your dish, it'll get a little bit too much water. So you want to go kind of sparingly with the bell peppers, and take that little bitter part out there.
You are smooth.
Just put them together.
Look at that, man. He's tough with the knife.
We'll do. Yeah, stand back now. If I yell, you'll know what happened. So I just cut them up to, I'll get me a little variety of color here.
It's got a little kick to it, doesn't it?
It does have a little kick. Now, I like cilantro. Anybody like cilantro?
What is it?
It's the next thing to parsley, except it's kind of got a minty taste. It's a very, very fresh taste. A little bit of this goes a very long way.
Does it help bad breath?
It does. It will actually help. You need some.
I know, that pepper.
Thank you, sir. I got some gum over here.
Okay.
Just kidding, Coach.
No, that pepper got me.
Yeah. So you want to use this very sparingly in your dish. Now, how many of you can tell me how many calories does an egg have in it?
Oops, excuse me.
Can you tell? It's right over here.
I need my eggs. Oh, there they are. Right there, Coach. How many of you can tell me how many calories one egg has? Yes, sir.
Nine.
Well, you're very close. Just add a zero to that. About 84 calories, roughly. How many of you can tell me how many calories an egg white has in it? Okay?
86.
Reverse that. There's about 16 calories in one egg white. I don't like to use the artificial egg, so what I do is I separate the egg whites. Now, what I'll do is I'll end up using one whole egg, generally, in this recipe, and four or five egg whites. So how do you separate an egg white? Here's the way I do it. Well.
Very carefully. Yeah, very carefully.
Very carefully. And I'll just switch from one to the other, and you eventually now need to throw the rest of this way.
This is a little gooey mess.
Yeah, the one big thing is actually you want to cut your vegetables first, because the last thing you want to do is you want to separate the egg whites. Now, if you get one that accidentally falls off, then that counts as your egg yolk. So we'll go with I'm gonna go with four.
Now, how many calories is four again? I wouldn't pay any attention.
Okay, there's about 16 calories in each egg white, so you got about 64 calories there. Okay,
I'm with you.
You guys keep up with me. So I got about 30 in the we'll say 30 in the oil maximum.
Okay.
And how many is that? I've gotten three.
That's three.
Anybody in math? Anybody got a calculator?
Anybody got a calculator? We're gonna figure up the total calories in this, because this is very healthy. And these. All right, here goes my one egg yolk. So that's what it's going to look like. Now I'm going to wash my hands off.
Need to take a shower?
Yeah, I got to
stop
take a shower.
For a minute?
Yeah.
So we're talking about really something that's really not too fattening for Super Bowl Sunday. You can eat and get by with.
This is for breakfast, and it's really a good breakfast. I'm not, this is not an omelet, but it's going to cover a plate and look like a lot of food, which it really is, but it doesn't have many calories. Now, I like to use, you can use canned salmon if you want. I like the red salmon because it's got a much higher content of omega-3s and omega-6s and 12s or whatever the number is. But I like to grill some salmon and use it as leftovers and just take that salmon and put it in my dish. So I'll take a strip of this salmon and very lightly just kind of mash it up. Noticed I did wash my hands before I did this, right?
We appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you, Coach.
Just don't pick your nose.
I won't do that. Now, I've also, we've got some green onions. I like green onions. You can use regular onions if you want. If you don't like onions, leave them out. If you don't like the hot peppers, leave them out.
The peppers are pretty hot.
Yeah, they're not bad, are they?
No, they're good.
Yeah. So what I'll do is make sure that these things are washed. So I'm going to take a couple of these. I don't use a lot of the onions. So by the time I'm done.
I like the part where he just starts throwing the food around. That's more your my speed.
This is more like the way I cook at home in my kitchen. Now, I need a fork. And what's the fork, Coach?
I don't know, I'm gonna look for them. I'm just like
there we go.
I'm finding my way as we go.
And basically, I just stir this up.
So it is kind of like an omelet, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It is kind of like an omelet.
With a kick.
And of course, you just take this. Now put your pan back on. Pour it right in the top. Spread it out a little bit. And you're going to end up with the Super Bowl Sunday salmon surprise. Now, what does it look like? It was very difficult for me this morning not to eat this, but this is what it comes out looking like. And that's pretty stylish, huh? When you think about it, you put it on the plate. Now this is the same, that's a lot of food. Put your garnish on there, tomatoes, whatever you want to add to it. Now, how many calories it's got in? Let's figure that up. We got 4 times 16.
Calculator going.
64 calories with the eggs.
My man working on it.
About, we'll say 80 calories for the whole egg. That's 144.
Got it.
Okay. We got 30 for the oil. That's 174, right? We've got, I'm going to guess, and at total vegetables, we probably have 8 calories in there. We'll say 10 at the max, right? What else we got, Coach? The salmon.
Salmon.
We probably got as much salmon as we put in here. This one has 110 calories per serving. It's got 700 for the deal. We probably got 40 calories max in salmon. So what does that give us?
About 210.
210. It's full of omega-3s. Salmon's got omega-3s. The eggs are good. The egg whites are good for you. So you got a really healthy and a very, very tasty dish. So that's my Super Bowl salmon surprise.
How about giving these two guys a very nice round?
Bubba did good.
Now, obviously the scam's over, but it is, Coach and myself do appreciate having guys that come in and do this, and you guys do have a little fun with it. But we got one more cut I think we got to go to, right?
These are the outtakes, okay? These are the fun parts when you're putting something together. Now, let me tell you a little history about it. Tom and Dick and I were on a little tour. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, back it up, yeah. And I told Dick, I said, some friends of mine back home roped me into this cooking show. And he said, well, what's it about? So I told him, and he got this huge grin on his face, and he said, we've got 3 hours before we have got to catch the airport, catch the plane. So we just happened to have a camera with us and a couple of people,
And in a very short, what, 3 hours, we threw this thing together, and Dick had so much fun. So he called me last night wanting to know the progress, and he wanted me to tell everybody here a special hello. Dick Butkus, for those of you who may not be familiar with him, spent a long time in the NFL and is a National Football League Hall of Famer. They call him the Monster of the Midway, the most feared man in football. But I will tell you that off the football field, he's one of the nicest people that ever lived and the funniest.
God, I know it's corny, but you guys hang with us. We appreciate it. It's been a good show. We actually did cook today. It's the first time ever.
That's some real
cooking. That we actually did.
Some real cooking going on.
I mean, real cooking. I give you a little credit on that one. Tom, again, thanks. It's good
thanks
to have
Tim.
Your friends
good
come through.
Again.
Thanks,
Coach.
Thanks, buddy.
Coach.
Thanks,
appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Question. You're gonna see how many calories you're taking, huh?
Yeah.
You need to come up and eat some of this, man. We'll give you a shot at it, okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's it. Thank you. Thanks.
Bells will ring.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling.
Ding-a-ling-a-ling.
And you'll